back on 11th of February, just a few days ago, ISIS launched 30 mortar shells at this position where I'm standing, and the nearest one landed about 400 meters away, and they turned out to be chemical weapons. They haven't determined exactly what type of chemicals. We just went a moment ago and looked at the craters left by some of those. Couldn't get too close because the smell is still there of the chemicals that were in the mortar rounds. But the effect of those rounds was to sicken about 175 Kurdish soldiers who were here in these positions along the front line. And fortunately, no one was killed. But it shows that ISIS is still heavily contesting this area. It shows that they are at least experimenting with chemical weapons, which is very concerning, deeply concerning, and should be really big news back in the United States. But I can tell you here, it is a great concern. And it should be, because if ISIS has access to chemical weapons and is able to make them or has a stockpile that it's captured in Syria, those things could very easily be moved around the globe and be used with horrible effects. I'm out here looking at an open plain on the edge of Sinjar, and they were fortunate that when those rounds landed, the wind blew them sort of across the front line and then back out into that big field. But you can imagine what would happen if something like that was detonated in a crowded public arena or in a shopping mall or, God forbid, you know, a church or something like that. And it wouldn't result in, you know, hundreds of people injured. It would result in hundreds or maybe thousands of people dead. Mm. And it's clear that ISIS is, you know, certainly has the inclination to do that. And now it's looking like they may actually have the wherewithal as well.